Preparing my death.
Oh. Challenging to string together two absolute masterpiece performances. Bad Intentions' last fight was just that. It was a spectacular knockout victory.
And he's looking for more of the same. And to get more of the same, he's got to remember, it wasn't just his power. It was the way he set it up. It was all the little things that he did.
That's a solid right hand by Bad Intentions. Cox is showing you that sublime skill right now with that two-punch combo. James's cut is not looking good at all. I'm getting the sense that this fight could be stopped at any moment.
So the key is where the cut is. When the referee brings the doc up to look at it, he's going to look at whether or not getting worse will imperil his health down the road.
Reaching the halfway mark of this round. Takes a step back, then the counterpunch by Bad Intentions.
Very similar to what you see Floyd Mayweather do. You know, make a miss, pull that shoulder back, and then come right back with the counter.
Great movement to get away from those punches. Many may believe that in a matchup like this, power puncher versus power puncher, that he who has more power wins. But in a way, is it as simple as saying he who has more fundamentals wins?
Yes, absolutely. He who has a missile to get that onto the target, he's going to win.
Good block there by James. Cox is putting forth that hard work he did in training camp there, landing a crisp combination.
Keep doing what you're doing.
Oh, he just misses with that headshot. And that's the end of round one. James's corner has to keep him calm. That's the kind of cut that can send a fighter into fits.
Yeah, and a corner man into using crazy glue instead of adrenaline. I mean, that is a scary cut, as you just said.
Bad Intentions is landing a combination here. That's what he does when he's at his very best. A nice block by James. He got hit right there, but he also gave one. Solid effort by Cox.
Yeah, give him work. He's working the box.
That's a razor-sharp uppercut by James. Oh, he is stunned. He could go down. Well, that's the classic wet noodle foundation right there. He's on wobbly legs.
Yeah, and it's not al dente. It's really, really wet noodles.
Pulls the trigger right away with the left hand after getting tagged himself.
Keep that half moving.
Halfway through round number two. Cox's combination punching is working well here. He took a go of it to the body, but came up empty. All of a sudden, the tables turn. Cox is rocked.
What's good for you is good for him.
See, he's got his guard up really well that time, and it protects his head. Cox is doing a really good job of being defensively sound, of being patient, and waiting for that golden opportunity for some offense to come in the mix.
Well, that's exactly what he's doing. He's waiting for a mistake to be made. You know, he wants a lead out of his opponent right now so he can make a miss and bang, come right back with that hook.
And he's really doing a nice job of hitting the mark with the jab.
And that's exactly what he needs. And it's not hard to hit the mark when the mark's coming at you. The right choice of a punch.
Little volume punching to the body there. And that's the end of round two. James's head has turned into one big target for his opponent. And he cannot get out of the way of his attack.
No, he acts like a guy who gets insulted if you miss him.
Just ate a big uppercut. He's in bad shape. James is in a tough spot here. He could go down with that bad defense. Targets his opponent after blocking a shot. How about a return to sender with the left hand? Body shot lands. It was the right. Oh, a nice bad intentions is doing a good job of putting his punches together. His opponent's got to be wondering, how do I stop this?
Well, right now, you made a good point there, because right now his opponent is wondering too much. You know, he's just busy blocking the punches, wondering about the combinations. He's not getting off.
That is a sharp uppercut by Cox. Very nice work there. Jab, uppercut. A great hammering punch by Cox. Banking away a body shot with the right hand. A digging uppercut by Cox. Bad intentions is impressing the judges and himself with that right hand. Nowhere close that punch by James. Good work defensively by bad intentions. Plus, he landed that counterpunch.
Yeah, and he forced him to punch. He made him, he drew it out of him, and then he timed him beautifully.
I want you to pick his jabs. Throws a jab, parry it away, and you'll catch him, okay? You got that? It's gonna happen.
So with three rounds complete, we take a look at Teddy's scorecard.
You fucked up, right? Bye-bye, wish you luck with life. But I'll be damned if I let you manage to bless that blade and keep taking advantage. Look, man, yeah, you shook my hand, but that was back then. We're not good, fam. I'm the fool, cause I started to be cool with them. But I got schooled in the art of opportunism. I ain't the only one that walked away. Look around, everybody gone today. You all alone with your empty chest. So bury the bones with any regrets and keep those skeletons piled in stacks. Just drink your medicine, don't bite your glass. I tried to make a difference, but the only thing that changed was I gave you distance. I won't trust you.
James is thinking defense first right now, Teddy. I mean, you can just see it in him. He's thinking strictly, nice. Hey, what happened earlier, I don't want that to happen again.
And that's what his opponent wants him to think. So that's all you need to know, that you can't think that way, especially since that's not his style. Joe, if he was a counterpuncher, it'd be okay. You know, your defense creates offense when you're a counterpuncher. He is not that kind of fighter. He can't win this way.
Focus.
Not much action as he just ties up. A little give and take, and here comes the left hand. Right to the head with that right. He gets to him with an uppercut. Oh, man, he's in rough, solid. James has got to have better defense than that. He just let his opponent come in with that straight punch and score the knockdown.
Blit is gone.
Double up your head.
So he is able to get up to his feet after that knockdown. But Teddy, it's what's ahead that's the problem.
Yeah, we're getting a peek right now into his heart, into his soul.
Keep working the body.
Solid straight right hand. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. That worked out really well. Throwing off the right hand after getting tagged like that. Took a shot, now he gives a left. James's inability to get away from his opponent's left hand is so evident.
And it's gonna stay that way if he doesn't change something. He needs to move the other direction, away from that punch.
Straight right hand, but didn't score with it. upstairs. And that's the end of round four.
Bro, punch.
James's Batman is going to turn his
cage. Without sure
that is a bad gash.
And I'm wondering what he's using in there. You know, you can only use certain things, Avertine, adrenaline, and thrombin. I'm wondering if he's using legal things right now, because that's the kind of cut that tempts you to use crazy glue.
Bad intentions has got a way of just getting away from that punch. You see, he comes over the top with that right hand, a real solid shot. Showing us that he is sticking with the game plan. But keep in mind, that game plan had him down earlier in this fight. What would you be telling him right now, Teddy?
Well, first of all, you got to explain to him very quickly and very clearly why he got caught. You can still do the other things that we thought going into this fight is still going to work, but make an adjustment. It's not that you didn't do the thing that could work, you didn't do it properly.
You missed that uppercut. Bad intentions is able to land a nice clean left hand. Big shot, the right came clean. James is just being swarmed. He just got stunned. He got absolutely nailed. To land these headshots.
Yeah, you got to remind them, you're not getting paid any bonus, no extra money for taking punches. You might get paid a little extra if you start delivering some, though.
Teddy, what would you recommend based on what we're seeing here tonight?
Well, two aspirin and then go, oh no, actually, I would say a little counterpunching would be just what the doctor ordered.
That's a better prescription for him. Is doing very nicely on the outside here in this fight. He's committed to the combination punching now. It's working out well up top. Right hand downstairs.
Come on, kid, focus.
Unable to land clean by James. Ox is scoring with that right hand. Good combination to the head. Targeting that head with the combination punching. Comes right back at him with a left hand. Bad intentions is going about his business just the way you want to see him do it. He's just boxing smart throughout this fight here in these middle rounds.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, if you're a guitar player, keep strumming that nice melody with the guitar. Don't try to play the drums. You know, don't hit those cymbals. You know, just keep pulling those strings. Keep pulling those strings beautifully.
And round six comes to an end.
Right.
One of his eyes is completely shut. They want this fight to continue on. They want to give themselves every chance they have to win it. What do they need to do?
Well, what they need to do is be very calm in the corner, get pressure on that cut, get the right medicines in there, and maybe find a way to fool around in the corner somehow, dump some water, you know, in the corner where the referee has to spend a little bit more time cleaning it up. They want to get a little bit more seconds.
He fires one right back after taking one. Gotta love the work by Cox. Combination to the head. Oh, and he's got something for him himself, and it's a left hand. He missed by a mile. That wasn't even close by bad intentions. Holding on. Bad intentions. His combination punching working out well there. He landed three solid shots. James's defense is now serving him well. Nice job blocking that punch. Up top with the right hand. He is damaged badly there. Oh, and there you go. How is this going to go on? What's the deck.
Well, he's getting practice at it, so he might figure it out.
His body shot.
It's over. This fight is over. Bad intentions is. Corner is already celebrating. His opponent unable to beat the count. Cox is your winner by knockout. Not
do it. Let's do it.
Let's see how you do with some sparring.
Be still.
Hi, everybody. I'm Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Adams.
first round underway in this scheduled 10-rounder. Cox is trying to repeat his last outing. Remember that impressive knockout he had, Teddy?
Yeah, I don't know if he should remember. Maybe he should have a short memory, because if he goes in there looking for the knockout, he might take away the most important part of his game, the jab, the thing that set it up.
Sound defense. Good block that time by James. Oh, that's good stuff. Fire it right back with one of his own. Good work by Cox. Right hand over the top. Very accurate with it. There's the headshot, but he parries it away. Good step back. Counter punch there.
Beautiful.
That was really well done. Targeting the jab and then thundering home with the uppercut. Takes one, gives one. The right hand scores well. Every fight takes on its own unique personality. And this fight looks like it's going to be a matching of wits, a technical sport.
Yeah, if it was a chess match, it wouldn't be a lot of knights jumping over to castles. It'd be a lot of pawns moving forward very steadily.
Well-placed counterpunch by Bad Intentions. Cox is doing well here with that two-punch combination. During your training career, is this the type of matchup that you liked when you had a power puncher facing another power puncher?
No, I hated it. I never wanted to fight a big banger. I wanted to be the only guy in that ring that brought that to the party.
Dismisses his opponent's headshot. Good combination to the body. Bad Intentions is probably sitting back right now saying, hey, I got everything figured out. Coming off of a sensational round he just saw, he was able to do some serious damage to his opponent.
Yeah, you know what really did it was that left hook to the liver, that body shot. You know, that's like going into a restaurant, you get a stain on
your
jacket. You know,
what are you
and
waiting?
The stain just doesn't come out.
You want this fight?
You know, you go to your cleaners, it's still there. Those body shots, they don't come out. They stay with you round after round. And
James is stunned by that shot. Cox is so dangerous with that accuracy, a two-punch combination landing. Nice block by Bad Intentions. His right hand did a nice job that time. That worked well for him. Cox is showing you a little defensive skill there. Able to move away from that punch. The old 1-2 scores for him. And coming upon the halfway mark of this 3-minute round. Good block by James. Takes one, but gets one. Good work by James. Very accurate two-punch combo by Bad Intentions. Oh, a big shot. A big shot comes home for him.
And he walked right into it.
I shake it off.
Nice strike after catching one by Cox. Bad Intentions is showing you what it takes to be the best in this business. Good, crisp combos. And this round comes to an end. It is a round that was highly entertaining. These guys really put forth quite an effort.
But they both have high engines. They have motors that never stop going.
James' defense, is it ever good? Look at how easy he's able to block those punches. Good shot to the head with that right hand. He is not in good shape. He could be on the big shot. James is unable to stand that combination. action.
That's what happens when you cover a little slow.
So now the question becomes, after that knockdown, and he has gotten up, how does he survive?
So one of the ways he survives is if he's been taught, have good habits, have good fundamentals been put there. You're going to find out right now. He needs them right now.
Oh, look at that. He's hurt. But hey, I give him credit. He's smart enough to know what to do now.
Yeah, the referee needs a crowbar to separate him.
Good right hand. Cox's defense is paying off now. Coming to the halfway point of this third round. Flush right hand to the head. Cox is the kind of boxer that wants to do just that. Find the target, get the combination working, land both punches. Bad Intentions is doing a really nice job here. I mean, putting his punches together. This is what you're supposed to look like as an offensive fighter.
Yes, it is, especially when you have a guy in front of you putting the earmuffs on. You know, you cover up the way that his opponent is, you're supposed to put them together. One or two are going to be blocked, but when you put them together like that, they're going to get through.
Good clean shot, returning fire. Well done by James. James is showing you that sublime skill right now with that two-punch combo. And round three comes to an end.
Great. You're making it hard to make it.
Round number four under.
Faster, sooner.
James is making for a tough target there. He gets away from that punch. Now hugging on the inside. Come on, straight right. Right hand over the top, very accurate with it. Solid play. James has been hurt. Oh, he's hurt.
Did you see that?
This is going to take some guts to get up from this. Once again, he goes down. James is up from the knockdown, but what we really want to look for is how he reacts in the coming moments of this fight. Throws out the jab, and then brings back the uppercut up top. What a great job! He gave one right back in return. Nice work by James. Combo lands to the head. Scores well to the head with the right hand. James's inability to get away from his opponent's right hand is costing him.
He continues to pull straight back, and he's still in the path of the punch.
Straight right was lined up, but he missed.
Stay away from that power hand, okay? Keep circling away from that power hand. I need you to keep moving side to side, all right?
Start of a new round, but will it be much the same? James has been down numerous times tonight, Teddy.
Well, if there was a mercy rule like there is in Little League Baseball, guess what? It would be invoked right now, and this would be over.
Right back to it upstairs. Cox's punch is far off the target. Boxing 101, jab followed by the straight. James is looking for a way to get back into this fight, Teddy, because, you know, his way about being a good, steady, solid boxer is not winning this fight right now in these middle rounds.
So you're absolutely right. So, you know, the problem is he hasn't been able to gain the respect of his opponent, has not been able to slow him down.
What impact from that uppercut by Cox. Cox is putting forth that hard work he did in training camp there, landing a crisp combination. James is banged to the noggin. He just missed that shot up top. James is not just loading up. He's landing. Oh, he is stunned. He could go down. And this round comes to an end. In between rounds here, James's eye is completely swollen shut. What would you be telling him?
Oh, this is going to sound a little tiny harsh, but guess what? It's a tough business. I told him, you have two eyes, right? Use the good one.
And now targeting his opponent with the overhand right. His opponent is opening up and coming forward, so I would think there's some opportunities that exist.
Yeah, I think some counterpunching opportunities. Opportunities not on the front end.
He is damaged badly there. Big, big shot he just scored with. Well, he's been there before, and now he's there again. He got four.
He can't afford to keep going on that floor. You have to wonder when the referee's going to step in now and stop this.
Hurt, but he keeps coming forward.
Yeah, too tough for his own good.
And oh, what a good strong uppercut by Cox. Not hitting his mark there, going upstairs. Good one, two by James. Comes right back at him with a left hand.
My kid, focus.
James is able to avoid that punch. James has got to deal with it. Oh, there it is! Can you believe that? What a huge punch! You couldn't have seen that one coming.
And those are the ones you usually don't prepare for. You prepare for the ones that are more sophisticated, the ones that are a little tighter in the gym. You don't have training for these.
And it's over! This fight is over! James is smashed, and he can't get up. Unable to beat the count. I like the way he finished this tonight, Kenny. Bad Intentions is your winner by knockout in a fight that he controlled throughout.
I'm glad you like it. It does his partner, or more importantly, the trainer, his manager, his promoter like it, because that means that he's going to be easy to sell now to television.
For Kenny Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. Have yourself a great evening.
Either middle, honestly, either are fine, because as long as it's close enough to their resources and all that shit, it's easy, you know what I mean? But maybe that little hallway is a good one. We could do two in the hallway, two upstairs somewhere. I mean, whatever you think is best, my dude. We could probably do a couple furnaces, like, between the fireplace and the, or sorry, between the workbench and the storage. Probably do, like, one or two there. Yeah, between the workbench and, like, all the storage shelves, all the boxes. We could probably do one or two there, between, like, up against that wall. And then maybe, like, one or two in the sleeping room or something? Or, I don't know. Like, maybe, like, one on each side of the research table. Like, one on the left, one on the right. out who's watching my stream. Does it still say to, are you the only group? I mean, I'm bad. Not true. I was not good at fighting games before you taught me how to play Mortal Kombat. No, I'm not, I'm dead ass. You don't remember, Stefan, when you, no, you don't remember, exactly, yeah, dude, no, you don't remember, though, like, I, you asked me, you were like, yo, you have Mortal Kombat, and I was like, yeah, but I never play it, ever. Georgie, if she wants, I'm live on YouTube. She can watch me win the title fight. Trying to get some views, bro. Trying to get some views, yo. My name, first last, yeah, hell yeah, first last. Do you know my last name means? Which is why my dad's name is the best. My dad's name is, bro, my dad's name is Richard. But your mother don't pay our bills. Yeah. But the idea of Richard Dick Ring. My dad is Dick Ring. Have you ever seen the movie Jackie Brown? Do you know what Robert De Niro looks like in Jackie Brown? Can you picture it? That's my dad's spitting image. Yeah, literally spitting image. If I need views. Stefan always told me to stream out here. That's for what? No one's gonna watch. No one has. Oh yeah. I actually want to play that again. They made a lot of updates, and I had a really enjoyable time. Frustrating, but enjoyable. Getting stuck, but like we were getting better vehicles and learning it and putting it into low gear. I realized how much it helps. And just like all this shit, like it was making so much more fun. Yeah. Title time, baby.
Good evening, and we welcome you to this night of World Championship pay-per-view action. Alongside my partner, Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. And we welcome you to the MGM Grand here on the Vegas Strip in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada. Such history has been made here through the year, and now we add more as it's the site for this championship fight. 12 rounds in the light heavyweight division. Each man comes into this fight supremely confident, expecting to deliver a W. His confidence is really showing through as he makes his way to the side. One flame, one bonfire, let it burn higher. I never show signs of fatigue or turn tired, because I'm the definition of tragedy turned triumph. This David ain't the liar. I made it to the eye of the storm, feeling torn like they fed me to the lions. Before my time start to wind down like the Mayans, I show them how I'm not grind down like the science. It sounds like a riot or hush. It's so quiet, the only thing I hear is my heart. I'm inspired by the challenge that I promise. Standing out of outwit, the moves like a wild warrior, but not a coward. You can't escape, the history to choose meant to make. This is a 12-rounder. Here's round number one. Box's goal is to leave this ring with a title.
Fulfill his dream. This is what he's been thinking about since he's a 12-year-old boy and he first laced those gloves on.
That's a forceful two-punch combo by Bad Intentions. Cox's right hand working well that time. He scored well.
Boy can
big
fight
puncher though. Here in front of us, going up against a guy who can do a little bit of everything. A boxer,
watch my
puncher, well-skilled, good athlete, well-conditioned.
I'm trying to counter punch for a few rounds.
Is going
to
be in trouble, especially as the fight goes late. He's going to get more and more desperate, and he's going to look for that one bomb. And usually, when you know it's coming, you can avoid it.
Keep your head moving. Hits him in the mug with the right. Went to the body there, but unable to connect. Here's a moment here as you see the step back counter punch where you realize this is the sweet science, not just some raw savagery swinging out there.
Look at the little subtleties here, Joe. What he does is he forces him into a position to stop the punch. And then when he stops, steps back, makes a miss, and comes right back.
Unbelievable pace here tonight. Both guys have no plans of having this fight go far. I'm sure the frame of reference for most is Hassler Hearns.
Yeah, you wonder if he's going to live up to that. So far, so good.
That attention, movement helped out there. He avoided that punch. You know, his opponent's doing a good job of just being patient now and looking for that one good shot.
Well, you know, the landscape of this business, the history of this business is littered with guys that they've had someone hurt, they get a little careless, they get caught. We better watch out that he doesn't get put on that landscape.
How you doing? You okay? Now, I need to use your feet. Move around the ring. You got that? Okay, now let's go.
Got him leaning. Oh no, I think my shit just died.
Final 10 seconds of round number two. A well-targeted jab that time. Bad intentions and statistics really shine in that last round. You can see that he was able to land more punches than his opponent. Now, it's not black and white. You land more punches, you win the round. But in this case, I do think he's up on the scorecards based on that round.
Yeah, I believe he is too. You know, you're looking at it, and you just feel that he's got control of the pace, the tempo. You know, he's winning the fight, but there's a risk there because he's starting to throw a lot of punches.
Oh, and a big right hand lands. Big, big shot comes crashing home. One shot and down, Teddy.
And now he's going to have to find a way to clinch. He needs time to recover.
So he goes down, but able to get up to his feet. Teddy, what should he be thinking about now?
Well, right now, just surviving, but if he survives, then he better figure out why he was put on the floor.
Smart punch right there. The uppercut worked. Committing to the work downstairs with the left. Commits to the overhand right, and it serves him well. Took a shot, now he gives a left. Accuracy an issue there, didn't land that straight right hand. And now he's targeting upstairs. He's committed to that left hand, and it's working out. He has his target, he lands a straight right. Teddy, he did a smart thing right there. Just created enough space and then landed the counter punch.
Looked like the will of the wisp, the old great Willie Peck. Made him miss, made him pay.
Cox is probably thinking to himself that he found an early answer. The counter punch doing damage here.
And his opponent's thinking, what the heck am I doing? Am I shadow boxing? Because I'm not finding nothing, but I tell you, if I am shadow boxing, that shadow, it has a little bit of a punch. It bit me back.
Left, right, come on, baby.
Oh, and he returns fire with a left hand. Headshot lands with a hook. Good accuracy with that uppercut. And that does it for this round.
Relax. Doing great. Keep the pressure on him. Keep it on him. No need to get excited.
Well, let's look at Teddy's scorecard through three rounds. He got hit right there, but he also gave one. Solid effort by Cox. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. Great stuff. He fires one right back after taking one. Gotta love the work by Cox.
Hey, keep your hands up.
And now he's targeting upstairs. He scores with the jab. Oh, he doesn't look good at all right now, Teddy. Not at all. We saw him knocked down earlier. And now, things opened up and he was able to place the right hand well. Look at that. And he goes down for a second. Does he have enough this time to rise up and continue on? And it's all over. Bad intentions is hand to be raised in victory. He scores the knockout here tonight.
That's it. That's it. Give me the belt. Give me the fucking belt.
Cox has got himself a world title belt. Oh, what a scene. For Teddy Atlas, this is Joe Tessitore saying goodnight from ringside. If you get down on your luck, you can stand out with a hand out. But nobody can fuck out here in the streets.
Yeah. Hook on an uppercut, I think. Who's worrying about you, baby? When you wild now, running around in these streets.
Drama, living with the police right behind you. It's always more than a slight reminder. We living in a war zone like Rwanda. Before I go back to the Heavenly Father, pray for me if it ain't too much bother. Whatever don't break me and make me stronger. I feel like I can't take too much longer. It's too much lying and too much frying. I'm all cried out cause I grew up crying. They all got a sales pitch, I ain't buying. They're trying to convince me that I ain't trying. We uninspired, we unadmired. And tired, and sick of being sick and tired. Of living in a hood with the shots of fire. We dying to live, so to live we dying. You just like I am.
Out in the streets, where I grew up.
I got over.
First teachers, not to give
a fuck.
I got over.
That type of thinking can't get you nowhere. Somebody, somewhere. Somebody's gotta care. And I
warfare and suspended animation. We ain't trying to go nowhere out here in these streets. We're so young and all alone.
That's good.
Let me turn off my switch so you have to be right back. I'll be right back.